Okay, here's the first active figure that's in the WebAssign, but it's optional to actually go through the answers, but I really recommend you go through them. They relate to figures and discussions in the textbook, but of course these can be animated. And here we have a car parked at the 30 meter position, and it's just sitting there right now, and you've got a displacement versus time graph, and displacement is in meters, and it's got a positive and a negative direction. Again, there's Youngbluth right there, and there's Trunco over here on the right. If you can picture that standard setup we had, one-dimensional setup we had in the in class the other day. And this is a car that can not only go at constant speed like those little toy cars, but it can go slower and it can go faster and it can change direction. So we got a little bit more complicated graph here than what you're used to seeing in with the little toy cars. So all you do is click start and watch the car in association with the plotted graph. Goes from A to F, and you can see the corresponding positions for all those letters. Now you can hit reset. From A to B, it starts out going to the right, and notice that you have a slope. You have a slope that is a positive slope when it starts out. So again, it's starting at the 30 meter position at time zero. At time zero, you've got a 30 meter position. It's got a positive slope. That curve at the initial, at time equals zero, it's got a positive slope. So it's moving to the right, moving in the right hand direction. And that initial slope changes to a slope at point B that's what? Well, think in your back of your mind, that's a flat slope. If you take the tangent line there at B, that's zero slope. So it stops at point B. And you see what happens next. Between B and C, it's quote-unquote speeding up in the backwards direction. You've got that tangent line drawn there at B, and it becomes a negative slope as it gets towards C. So it's becoming steeper, yes, it's getting faster, but it's a negative slope, so it's going to go in the negative direction. So watch going from A to C. There's B, stops for an instant, and comes back to C. Comes back to about the 40 meter position there. Okay, and then between C and D, and then on to E, it's approximately a straight line. I'm looking at it differently here. There's some slight curves to it, but looks like to me it's constant speed between C and D. But since that between C and D is a negative slope, it's a negative speed. Okay, there goes the A, stops at B, speeds up in the other direction, constant speed between D and E, and then between E and F, look at the slope. You got a steep negative slope at E, and then what happens to the slope as time goes on to 50 seconds? It gradually gets shallower and shallower and shallower until at F, you have a flat slope, you have a zero slope, and it stops. Okay, watch that whole thing one more time. There you go. And you can go back and answer some of those questions in the WebAssign for practice if you want. But that takes some of the motion analysis a step further.